manager and trainer, Hyun Chi Kim, who fought for the World Junior Lightweight Championship, and his time, got to feel good about his fighter at this point.
And despite the fact that Mancini got hurt in the middle of the last round, at the end of the round, he seemed to be just about gaining a little control in the fight. Oh, that punch could change things right back around the other way. That's the kind of fight it's been.
Vegas, and what you're seeing now is the way it's been. 2-6. Right edge to Mancini in our scorecards. The rest of this fight will probably determine the winner because it is close.
Mancini's winding up to throw that right hand now. Legs far apart, winding up to throw the punch.
Well, Mancini wants to punch hard, and he feels he can do that by telegraphing, by really putting his whole body behind him. But he can throw punches short. Inside punches, upper punches.
That's going to be the difference, Ray. Short punches.
Short punches do a great deal of damage.
Kim is a determined fighter, though. Anytime the tides starts to go against him, you can just see him gritting his teeth. He says, I have to get back in the action, and he does.
Well, he pushes himself, you know, and he goes back, gets back into the fight.
Okay,
looking to his corner, getting instructions from his manager, trainer, another Kim, no relation. And the pace starting to show itself somewhat here in the seventh round, under a minute to go. Grueling pace.
That punch thrown by Kim landed in Mancini's chest. That punch may not look hard, but those punches to the chest really hurt.
And Mancini pounding to the body. Both fighters holding a little more here in the seventh round. There's no surprise. Not unlike the pace established last night in that great fight between Arguello and Breyer. Non-stop, pounding, punishing blows. Under 30 seconds to go here in the seventh. Little redness near the right eye of the challenger Kim now. Kim scoring to the body. Coming to the end of the seventh round. Challenger Kim, now back to live action in the eighth round from Las Vegas. Tim Ryan, Gil Clancy, and Sugar Ray Leonard watching a very exciting lightweight championship.
Tim, they've changed Kim's style. He's actually dancing around now. At least he started out off the round that way. First time in the fight.
A little swelling around the left eye of the challenger Kim. One of his damage earlier in the fight.
Kim started off very flat-footed, and now he's a little mobile. Now. He's using the ring, and he's loosened up a lot more than he did for the earlier rounds.
What he does, he waits for Ray to snap that jab out, then he counters with that straight left hand, and there it was, just when we said it.
It just collided with heads again.
Kim's corner, shouting instructions to him. Lands that left hand again. That's his best punch, and he has done well with it.
Kim really goes to the body very well. Gets inside and just rips those body shots.
Good tough right hook, good solid straight left hand. Those are his primary weapons. Mancini banging into the body, and Kim comes off the ropes and ties him.
Kim was covering up. He blocked most of those punches.
There's that left landing again.
Tim Mancini's jab is ineffective. When he tries to jab, he's jabbing across his body with his legs wide apart, and he's easy to counter with that straight left hand of Kim's. He has to move his head more and change his balance a little bit.
Mancini can't afford to try to deliver that left uppercut on the outside because, again, that left hand of Kim has been very effective. It's been fighting his mark.
There's some redness over the left eye of Ray Boom Boom Mancini, the champion. Under a minute to go in the eighth round. His nose, which usually bleeds quite easily, has not been a problem for him. happy with the way that it is healed up, and they don't expect it to be the easy bleeding problem it's been in the past. Cartilage problem he had in his nose. Right hand lead by Mancini landed.
Kim now is really trying to measure Mancini with that overhand left. You notice he extends that right jab, and he'll fake, and then he'll come in with the left hand.
And there's a 30-second mark. You saw Kim looking to his corner, taking instructions from there.
First time in the fight, Kim's mouth is wide open. Tim, he's gasping for breath. I think the pace is starting to tell him. There he is, holding inside.
Well, we can see it starting to show in round seven. It has been a tough, grueling pace, and he lands a good combination. Final seconds of the eighth round.
And here's that right hook and straight left hand by Kim just at the end of the last round. It really rocked Mancini.
We're back live in round nine with the challenger, Kim, making this a very close fight as we see it at this point. Swelling around the Korean's left eye. Ray Boom Boom Mancini had some swelling around his left eye.
Kim is able to get those punches off very quick now. And now, I'm surprised. I'm very impressed now. He's able to see on his toes now.
Again, Tim, we have another tough fight to judge. Good, straight left hand by Kim. Rock Mancini.
Yes, it did. Ray stays there and slugged back with
him. That right hook of Kim just landed also.
Tim, the point I was trying to make, this is a tough fight to judge. Two rounds in a row, the last 10, 15 seconds, Kim landed the good punches. But the whole early part of the round and the middle of the round all belong to Mancini. How do you judge a round like that?
Well, I think you should judge it over the 3 minutes. We've been through that recently. But I'm not sure I agree with you that Mancini had the best of it over the 3 minutes. I gave the last two rounds to Kim.
Mancini was shocked, hit again with a good punch.
It's that straight left hand, Ray. He just can't seem to get away from it.
With a nod to his corner over the shoulder of Mancini that he's hearing their instructions and he'll try to follow them.
Kim just sticks that right jab out, measured, and here comes a straight left hand.
Whatever the scorecards say, Mancini is in a fight for his championship. Ninth round scheduled for 15.
Kim here has blocked the punches. Defense inside.
The Youngstown fans here exhorting Ray Boom Boom Mancini with a chant of Boom Boom, trying to lift his game. Under a minute to go in the ninth. Came a little short with that left that time.
He has that left ready all the time though, Tim. That is a weapon, that left hand of Kim, straight left hand. Comes in right on the mark.
We've got a really exciting lightweight championship bout. And whatever Ray Boom Boom Mancini expected from Kim, I don't think he expected quite this much. Under 30 seconds to go. He had respect, he had concern, but I don't think any of the Mancini people expected Kim to be this difficult, this long.
Again, Kim has that straight left hand, and Ray is winding up to throw that right hand. He's telegraphing the punch. Big difference.
Coming to the end of the ninth round, Mancini trying to pin Kim against the ropes.
This is where Mancini should be doing his work.